Hello and welcome back to 7 Day Gaming. I'm your host, the Insomniac, and this is Secret of Evermore. We are about to fight the worst boss in this entire game. I mean, the absolute fucking worst. He is this game's bed of chaos. And it sucks. I'm not gonna read what you have to say, I'm not gonna dignify you. Not doing alchemy makes this fight so much harder, and it was already a pain in the ass. There's no skill to it, because you can't dodge any of his attacks, and you can't hit him with any of your regular attacks. It has to be either alchemy or the spear. And the fact that you can't go back and stock up on alchemy ingredients makes this even harder. Oh, and of course, his physical defense against my spear is way higher than his magic defense, which is how my alchemy is doing so much damage right now. Because they decided, it's like, they looked at this boss and they went, have we fucked over physical attack users enough yet? No? Yeah, let's keep going. Ow! That fucking drain. Well, as long as he doesn't plague us, I'm sure it'll be fine. Ow. And he's honey on that one. And he fucking blows us up again as soon as we're done healing. I fucking hate this boss. Pro tip, by the way, keep the dog alive. Also, he can stun you out of your attacks, but you can't stun him out of his. This would be very valuable right now if only I had the ingredients, but of course I can't. Ow. Probably should have used regrowth before I came into this fight. Ah, thought I had him there. I healed out of the one. Well, I'm gonna res the dog. Doesn't take any of my time. Because the thing is, if you resurrect the dog, sometimes he'll target the dog. Not always, though. God damn it! You guys want to see something beautiful? Yeah, at this point, I don't even care. I'll exploit a glitch. I'll break the sequence. Yeah, I'll come back and kill the Verminator at some point, because that's how you're supposed to get through this area. But this alternate path opens up. This alternate path opens up the instant you reach Ebon Keep. You can just go back from there to the giant chessboard and cross the bridge. It's an error in the way the game is coded, but I hate the Verminator boss fight so much. I simply cannot be bothered to fight him. Ever. Let me guess, 9? Yeah. That's a full heal. I'm not gonna worry about that. Yep. Colby, that'll be useful for when I eventually go back. Yep. Center by Queen of Ivor Tower wants to open the drawbridge. Yes, indeed. Time to follow along with this random eccentric stranger. I'm sure nothing bad can come of this. Meet the real Miss Queen Blueguard. Miss Queen Blue. Queen Blueguard, yes. Have we met? You've run through two evil twins before, and you haven't figured out this is just going to be a thing here. Two Dr. Ids. Evil twins everywhere. Fire Eyes, Horus, now her, yes. And there'll be another one in just a little bit, I'm sure.
Actually, does Professor Ruffelberg have an evil twin? I don't think so. I think he just has. Yeah, never mind.
Yeah, Mansion on the Hill. Terribly wrong. Stuck here ever since. They won't really care at this point. We've heard that story several times.
Yeah. Wasn't that bad until a few months ago? Quinn appeared, locked her in her dungeon, and took her place. Then, presented the King of Hypnotic Puppet Show, sent them into a trance.
Cadmetid Estate. Scheme under his nose. Move the kingdom across the ravine. How did you move an entire kingdom in a couple months? How did you move everybody in there and go make an entirely other castle to live in a couple months? They completed the city. That is a big construction project, and there aren't that many people there. There isn't even 100 people in the whole place. Ugh, whatever. Nobilia was bigger than this. People remain, let's see, Cecil, Rosa.
Is that old lady Rosa, or is she someone else?
Tinker, Struffelberg, the autistic guy in the entrance over there. Yeah. Troops clear of the castle. All.
Storms in here.
Yes. Well, the drawbridge is already down. That's how I got in. Imposter, and then the hatches. Set things strict. Some call beads. Yes. Not gonna need those for that. I'm gonna need that to clear out the rat in your entryway. So, thanks. Camellia. Camellia Bluegarden, apparently, is her name. Ah, yes. Alive. Must be a trick of the light. Unfortunately for you. Actually, fortunately, I could use the experience. Oh, you remember when these guys were a threat? Come here, hit me! Hit me, boy! Hit me! Hit me again! Come on! I dare ya! It didn't even make contact. Come on, come on, come on! Seriously, hit me. Give me your best shot. Hit me as hard as you can. As hard as you can. Boom! Boom! actually took a hit. A hit. Now these guys, on the other hand, are still annoying. You know what? I've got a much stronger sword. My attack has risen. Let's see if I can one-shot them. Without charging. God damn it. Nope, not quite. But I can two-shot them. Pain in the glass. Yes! Oh, this is a kid's game and they got that past the radar. It's awesome. Yes, hello, friend. No, it didn't. It provided some much-needed amusement. In particular, the vipers. What I want to know, actually, it's not your name, but how you got vipers here. Actually, how you got all those guys here. Those are from the other sections of Evermore. Yes, I am. Yeah. Machine zapped us in the lab. Space station. Yes. Omnitopia. Ruffleberg. Carltron. We're on Evermore. Ever since. Though in our case, thankfully, it's only been a couple days, like a week tops. Actually, keep track of how many times we've rested. I'll have to go back and check. I'll insert some number here later that says how long we've actually been here. Okay, that's how long we've been here. The imposter. Go back to Hover Tower. Sounds like a good idea. Taking a look. Orders from above. Probably not from God. Probably from Omnitopia. I don't think there's a single mention of any deity anywhere in this. They've got the sacred eyes of the... Yeah, they've got the diamond eyes of the sacred dark statues. They're sacred there, so there's some sort of religion, but they haven't mentioned any deities. Ever. Oh, actually, they did mention... two Egyptian deities back in the Egyptian area, but that's it. The Minotaur relates to ancient Greece, but that's all there. But in Gothica, they haven't mentioned anything. Probably because if they were to mention some kind of, they had church-like stained glass in that last hallway. I'm getting off track. How can we hear them? Actually considering this, but then I realize I'm not doing much magic in this round. I gotta stick to that, goddammit. Now let's see. gradually drains HP. It's better than it sounds. But I don't think I really want to get rid of too many of these. I mean, I don't really need the drain for me, do I? Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of that. Yeah, there's a much better alchemy formula around here somewhere. Explosion. Here it is. Yeah. It says destroys barriers, but it does more than that. It also I'm not going to be using that enough to care. It deals a pretty intense amount of damage. But here's that axe we're looking for. I'm gonna go grind for a bit and get that up to level 3. That'll have to do it for this episode. Granted, I'm doing a whole bunch of episodes this week, and they're pretty much all gonna be... That's unfortunate. Yeah, and most of them are gonna be Secret of Evermore. I'm only gonna be doing one episode about the Ever. Thankfully, I have today, tomorrow, and Sunday to do them. Dog got knocked out. I'll fix it. Or I won't, actually. Whatever. No, actually, I won't fix it. It seems mean, but I'm gonna need those dog biscuits. I don't have any way to restock. Gonna need the dog biscuits to keep rezzing the dog in the Verminator fight so it'll keep being targeted instead. I can't go down there, the Verminator's blocking the path. Here's the dungeon. Here's the way out. Yeah, I'm gonna do a little off-screen grinding. I'm gonna take revenge on the Verminator. But before I do, I'm gonna show you the path that he was talking about. Let's see, there's a shortcut around here somewhere real quick, just before... Here it is. Yeah, I found this while I was grinding. To get the spear up to level 3. Which apparently was not enough grinding to stand half a chance against the Verminator. I looked and see if other people had done no magic runs in the Verminator, and... Yeah, they have, but they all brought in a full stock of pixie dust, which I don't have. So, that kind of changes things, you know? If you remember what pixie dust does, it allows you to die and then revives you at 1 HP, giving you an opportunity to immediately fully heal yourself. Which I suppose I'd do with honey, because I still... Well, that isn't quite a full heal. And we're back where we started! That isn't quite a full heal. It bring me back up to 301, though, so close enough. And doing this actually removes all status effects as well, so it cures the plague if the rat has given it to you. Which is... also super helpful, because he uses the plague status effect a lot. God damn, you guys will see my two attempts at beating the Verminator beforehand at the beginning of this episode, so you'll see just how fucking obnoxious that prick really is. And yes, I only tried twice and gave up, because I hate that boss that much. Also, I lost that badly. I think I only got him down to like half health each time. Of course, it's not like we have a boss health bar. Would be nice if this game did have boss health bars, to be totally honest. That is one of the biggest things that it lacks. One of the biggest things it could use... Yeah, they could use some improvement.
just the... Another thing that could use some improvement is this. The damage values. You see, Lucio believes spears are the best when, for the most part, swords actually do more damage, but that's not what bothers me. I get that having the spear do more damage compensates for its inferior moveset and the lack of the silver sheath, but... yeah, but the axes have the worst moveset in the game, so why aren't they the thing that deals the most damage? That would make the most sense to me. Like, switch around... I mean, like, as it is, you've got the sword type weapon, then the axe does 5 more damage, and the spear does 5 more damage. But what would actually make the most sense is if you had the sword type weapon, then the spear dealt 10 more damage, and the axe dealt 20 more damage. Then the axe would be worth using. The only time you ever really use the axe... the only time you ever really use the axe in the entire game... By the way, does this remind you of something? It seems familiar to me, but I can't quite put my finger on it. Yeah. The only time you ever use the axe in the entire game is in the first area. Also... excuse me, I'm trying to talk here. Bricks. Also in the last area, the last 3 weapons that you get, the final sword, axe, and spear, all have 50. All have 50 damage. So, what the hell? Yeah. So this is where we're supposed to go. Obviously, despite the fact that I like this game, I still have a lot of issues with it. I think it could use a remake that fixes a lot of these issues. Hell, it wouldn't even have to be 3D. It could still be top-down. It'd still be pretty goddamn good. Nah, it'll never happen. We may see a remake of Secret of Mana, but never Secret of Evermore. Though I'd still pay for a remake of Secret of Mana. I'm gonna go do some off-screen grinding, and I will be right back. Alright, here we are. I got the Night Basher up to level 3. Went back to Woods to do it, because apparently the spiders, for whatever reason, also give 180 experience a pop, so... yeah, they're worth an awful lot. Such a weak enemy. I'm not actually going to use the Night Basher probably ever again. Well, it's time to take care of the Queen's little pest problem. Yeah. I'm just gonna nuke you. I'm gonna nuke you so hard. That doesn't seem like it did much. Because, I mean, you know, didn't immediately do damage. But he will take quite a bit of damage periodically from here on out. Oh, look! He returned the favor. But you know what? I have pixie dust now. I dare you! Whereas if you... Yeah. The thing with him is he's not actually that tough if you have alchemy or a lot of call beads when you run into him. But if you don't have either of those, you're basically fucked. I've seen people go through it, but they all had to use, like, pixie dust in order to get through. And I mean a lot of it, not just the little bit I used. No, that's right, I actually do need the Night Basher real quick. I only need the Night Basher to get through a few things. A few little barricades is all. Like that one. Not that I think that this axe would actually be capable of breaking a barrier of that size, but that, whatever. Okay, we are out. Now, I'm never gonna use it. In fact, I'm gonna go back to the sword. Even though, according to the stat screen, it does the least damage of the three of the silver sheath, makes it almost ludicrously overpowered. So, you know. Okay. So, next episode, we're gonna climb this tower. Now, this episode, I'm gonna kill this thing. They don't even give much experience or gold. They give 60 gold, which I guess is an okay amount. It's twice as much as the spiders. They only give 150 experience, while spiders gave 180. I don't get it. Oh well. Anyway, I think this episode has gone on long enough. We beat the Verminator after glitching past him. We met the Queen. We got orders from Tinker to climb this tower that his brother built for some reason. And... hell. We got a new weapon and got it up to level 3. That's a lot of progress for one episode. And the episode's already gonna be pretty long, so... yeah, I'm not gonna climb this out of this episode. We have to call it here. I'll see everyone tomorrow. So I'll be then. Remember to pick up a copy of this game, because it is seriously worth it. And... take it easy.